Fox 5 Health News. Doctors say the coronavirus is getting better at infecting people, and there are questions about whether the mutation will make the virus less deadly. Joining us now, Dr. Suraj Saggar from Holy Name Medical Center. He's also the co-host of the podcast, Recommended Daily Dose. All right, let's talk about the implications of this. Is this potentially why we're seeing younger people get more sick? Are they getting more sick, less sick? And also the vaccine considerations if we've got multiple versions of this thing floating around.
Yeah, hi, Steve. There's a lot to talk about here. So let's just take it from one step at a time and look at the background. So remember, the virus that causes COVID-19 is called SARS-CoV-2. And remember, a virus is not alive. It needs a host, i.e. a human, to replicate. So when it replicates, when it reproduces in the body, it makes errors, which are natural. If enough errors happen, that can lead to a mutation. And some of these mutations can lead to certain specific traits out there. So one trait in particular that this has been looked at is this mutation make the virus more likely to infect other people? And would it be less deadly? Scientists are now looking at this very mutation as it relates to something called the spike protein. Spike protein is what the virus uses to enter the cell. We should keep in mind that this has been looked at in the lab. What happens in the lab doesn't necessarily correlate well to what happens in the body. So we really have to see. This is a very preliminary information, indeed.
Gotcha.
But it appears that this particular variation spread in Europe, now throughout the United States, is a particular virus that we're seeing. Mm-hmm. And at least the possibility exists that it is more infectious but less deadly. Whether that's true, whether we have to wait and see how that plays out, certainly. But it's an interesting theory.
Indeed.
But again, what happens in the lab, it doesn't always correlate with what happens in real life.
Right. We got two more questions to get through quickly. We're banking basically everything on the idea of having a vaccine in about a year. That would be an unprecedented short timetable when it typically comes to something like that, right?
Ideal situation, 12 to 18 months. Very rarely do we ever have an ideal situation. We have a lot of vaccine candidates out there, about 18 so far. But, you know, whether this vaccine can truly come out, whether it will be an annual vaccine like influenza, or whether it will be something that has to be given only every couple of years remains to be seen.
Mm-hmm.
It's very exciting to see how technology has come together so quickly, but the answers to that question are still remain to be seen.
Gotcha. And just finally today, there was a new study saying hydroxychloroquine may help patients beat the COVID-19 virus. We've heard so much back and forth on this. What's your impression of this latest study?
Yeah, I have to tell you, Steve, this is just one particular institution, Henry Ford Clinic in Detroit, and it's a retrospective study. That means they looked back in time to see what patients may or may not have gotten. In medicine and science, we don't use retrospective studies at just one center to make any generalized information. I can tell you from my own experience, the most major medical centers, hydroxychloroquine didn't really pan out and didn't really offer any benefits to COVID-19 patients.
Gotcha. Very well. All right. Dr. Suraj Saggar, we appreciate it. Thank you very much for being with us.
Thanks, Steve.